So after resurrection, this particular group will say, Ya Vailana Mambasana Mimmar Kadina. After seeing the horrors of the day of Qiyamah. Now certainly, these people are not those who are obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the obedient people will be under the shade of the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will have nothing to worry about. These servants are the ones who disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who rejected Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who rejected the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who rejected the Anbiya alayhi musallatu wasalam sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The rejectors, they will say, Ya wailana man ba'asana mimmar qadina. So the rejectors, the sinners, from the time they had passed away until the time they will be resurrected, will they be in any kind of comfort in the grave? Will they be in a garden from the gardens of paradise, or will they be in a pit from the pits of Jahannam? They will be in a pit from the pits of Jahannam. Despite that, upon resurrection they will say, Ya Vailana, after witnessing so much punishment in the grave, upon seeing the horrors of the day of Qiyamah, the horrors of the grave will seem very insignificant to them. Hence they will say, Ya Vailana, may we perish. If only we were able to avoid this day of Qiyamah, this life hereafter. Man ba'athana, who has resurrected us? Mimmar qadina, from our resting place. From our resting place. After witnessing the punishment of the day of Qiyamah, the punishment in the grave will seem so insignificant that they will define the grave which was full of punishment as a resting place. Mimmar qadina. So if this is the difference between the punishment of the grave and the horrors of the day of Qiyamah, imagine the difference between the horrors of the day of Qiyamah and the horrors of the fire of Jahannam. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said that if there is no deliverance for a person in the grave, then the subsequent stages can only be harsher. It is for this reason Usman radiallahu anhu used to weep very much. The grave calls out on a daily basis, Ana baytul wahsha, I am the house of loneliness. Ana baytul dud, I am the house of worms. Ana baytul dhulma, I am the house of darkness. What we need to do, my friends, is to, number one, continually seek the refuge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the punishment of the grave. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min adabil qabr. Continuously, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min adabil qabr. And Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min fitnatil qabr. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min adabil qabr wa a'udhu bika min fitnatil qabr. Oh Allah, I seek your refuge from the punishment of the grave, and I seek your refuge from the trial of the grave. Because even in the grave, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test us. He will send Munkar Nakir, and they will say, Mar Rabbuka, who is your Rabb? Ma Deenuka, what is your religion? And he will be made to see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he will be asked, Ma taqulu fi hadar rajul? What do you say regarding this person? Do you know him? This test. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us refuge from the punishment of the grave and also the trials of the grave. So this is the first thing we need to do. And secondly, we need to make preparation for this time, for this stage. Because when we depart from this world, When the soul departs, this body will be laid to rest in the grave. And not after one day or one week, as soon as possible. Even the one who loves you the most will try his utmost to bury you as soon as possible. The one who loves you the most. The one who will be grieved the most. As soon as possible. It is human nature as well. And it is the command of Sharia also. And nobody will come with us. And if we will depart from this world with good amal, with good deeds, then when the people will carry us towards the grave after the Salatul Janaza, in excitement we will be saying, Qaddimuni, Qaddimuni, take me quickly, take me quickly. And if we depart from this world with evil deeds, we will be complaining and we will, where are you taking me? Why are you taking me? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that this person who will be crying out and saying, Ila aina tuqaddimuna, where are you taking me? Where are you taking me? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed the veil that lies between we the humans and this person in the janaza who is screaming and crying out, if Allah was to remove the veil and if we were to hear, if the humans were to hear how he is wailing and crying and screaming, then whoever was to hear him would become unconscious. That is how frightening his plea will be. So what must he be witnessing when he is being taken towards the grave? Imagine. So what we need to do is, number one, to make sure that we continually ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min adhabil qabr. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Hadrat Aisha radiyallahu anha relates an incident, and at the end of that hadith, Aisha radiyallahu anha says that after that, I used to hear Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after performing every salah, say, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min adhabil qabr. Oh Allah, grant me refuge from the punishment of the grave. Oh Allah, grant me refuge from the punishment of the qabr. And with that we need to make preparations. Stay away from everything that displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and carry out everything that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because when we carry out something that displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that brings destruction in this world. Destruction at the time of death and destruction in the grave also. And once we witness destruction in the grave, then definitely we will witness destruction on the day of Qiyamah, at the time of reckoning and on the Bulsira. So we have to make sure that when we depart from this world, we depart in a nice manner and we see pleasure in the grave. Because once we witness pleasure in the grave, inshallah we will witness pleasure on the day of Qiyamah, we will witness pleasure at the time of reckoning, and we will witness pleasure on the Pul Sirat, and we will be granted entry into Jannah without having to go in the